This conference will now be recorded.
Okay. Today's topic is leiomyoma of uterus. The clinical term of this leiomyoma is fibroids. So these are benign tumors that arise from the smooth muscle cells in the myometrium and are properly termed leiomyomas, but because of their firmness, often are referred to as clinically as fibroids. Fibroids because these are firm in consistency. And about 20% of the women above the age of 30 years harbor uterine myomas of varying sizes. So these are usually seen in reproductive age people. So malignant transformation can occur in less than 0.5% of leiomyomas. So symptomatic cases may produce abnormal uterine bleeding, pain symptoms due to compression of the surrounding structures and infertility. So usually the patients present with menorrhagia, metrorrhagia, dysmenorrhea, infertility, all these symptoms. The cause of leiomyoma is unknown, but the possible stimulus to the proliferation is estrogen. So these leiomyomas are estrogen dependent tumors. And what is the role of estrogen here? Some studies say that estrogen inhibits the tumor suppressor gene, that is TP53 gene. That's why there will be proliferation of the uterine smooth muscle cells leading to fibroids. Other possible factors implicated in this etiology are human growth hormone and sterility. So because estrogen is low in postmenopausal women, these fibroids automatically regress in these women. These tumors are associated with rearrangements of chromosome 6 and 12 that are also found in variety of other benign neoplasms such as endometrial polyps and lipomas. So coming to the morphology of fibroids, grossly these leiomyomas are typically sharply circumscribed, firm, gray-white masses with a characteristic horrid cut surface. They may occur singly but often occur as multiple tumors that are scattered within the uterus, ranging from small nodules to large tumors. So based on the location of leiomyomas, there are three types of leiomyomas: intramural, subserosal, and submucosal. Intramural leiomyomas are seen embedded within the myometrium, whereas subserosal lie immediately beneath the serosa, whereas submucosal lie immediately beneath the endometrium. So usually these submucosal leiomyomas these submucosal leiomyomas are present immediately beneath the endometrium and fills the endometrial cavity. So this is the picture given in your Harsh Mohan. So these are three types of leiomyomas: intramural, submucosal, and subserosal. These subserosal tumors gives the appearance of postulated appearance of the external surface of the uterus. This is the picture given in your Harsh Mohan. It is the section surface of the uterus showing multiple circumscribed firm nodular masses of variable sizes. These white arrows are showing submucosal leiomyomas, and the black arrow showing intramural leiomyomas. See the characteristic furled appearance of the cut surface of the leiomyoma, furled appearance of the tissue. This is another picture. This is the pregnant uterus having leiomyoma, large intramural leiomyoma. This is the opened up uterine cavity showing intrauterine gestation sac with placenta and a single circumscribed enlarged firm nodular mass in intramural location having gray-white horrid appearance. Okay. Usually these leiomyomas will cause infertility. So this is another picture given in Robbins. This is the uterus, cut open uterus. This is the cervix and this is the uterus. the uterus is showing multiple leiomyomas. Whenever we see multiple leiomyomas, we call it as leiomyomata, not leiomyoma. If there is only one leiomyoma, there is only one fibroid we can see in the uterus, we call it as leiomyoma. If there are multiple fibroids, we call it as leiomyomata. The uterus is open to show multiple submucosal, intramyometrial and subserosal gray white tumors, each with a characteristic whorled appearance on the cut surface. This is a submucosal, this is the subserosal, and this is the intramural tumor. So coming to the microscopy, they are essentially composed of two tissue elements, whorled bundles of smooth muscle cells admixed with variable amount of connective tissue. The smooth muscle cells are uniform in size and shape with abundant cytoplasm and central oval nucleus. So cellular leiomyoma has preponderance of smooth muscle elements and may superficially resemble leiomyosarcoma, but is distinguished from it by the absence of mitosis. So another variant of leiomyoma is cellular variant. So in the cellular variant of leiomyoma, we can see the smooth muscle cell proliferation compared to that of excess smooth muscle cell proliferation compared to that of the surrounding connective tissue. So we need to differentiate it, cellular leiomyoma, from that of leiomyosarcoma. Leiomyosarcoma is the malignant variant of the leiomyoma. So we need to differentiate cellular leiomyoma from that of leiomyosarcoma by seeing the number of mitosis. Okay. There are more than 10 mitotic figures in more than 10 high power fields. We can say it as leiomyosarcoma. And these are the secondary changes: hyaline degeneration, cystic degeneration, infarction, calcification, infection and suppuration, necrosis, fatty change, and sarcomatous change. You need to remember these things. So this is the microscopic picture showing smooth muscle cells in whorled pattern. And these are spindle shape with abundant cytoplasm, central cigar shaped nucleus with perinuclear halo. Okay. And these are benign appearing, not malignant appearing, because the NC ratio is normal. And this is the hyaline change, hyaline degeneration seen within the tumor tissue. So this is another microscopic picture showing this is the leiomyoma. It is a well circumscribed mass showing proliferation of smooth muscle cells. This is the high power view of this tumor showing spindle shaped cells, which are normal looking but not abnormal. There are no mitotic figures and the NC ratio is within normal limits and there is no hyperchromacity. Okay. So this is the picture in our lab. So this is the cut open hysterectomy specimen. This is the cervix and this is the uterus. This part is the cervix and this is the uterus. The uterus is completely filled with the single intramural leiomyoma. This is large intramural leiomyoma. And this is the nodes of this specimen. This is a cut open hysterectomy specimen measuring 12 into 9 centimeter. Cut section shows single gray white solid whorled tumor of 11 centimeter diameter pushing the endometrial cavity to one side. This is the endometrial cavity. This is the fibroid. It is pushing the endometrial cavity to one side. So the diagnosis is large intramural leiomyoma of uterus. And this is the another specimen in our lab. It is showing multiple leiomyomas. That's why it is leiomyomata. There are three fibroids we can see. Two are subserosal and one is intramural fibroid. And this is the hysterectomy specimen showing this part is the cervix and this is the uterus. Showing uterus and cervix with three fibroids. And this is the nodes of the specimen. This is a cut open hysterectomy specimen measuring 12 into 12 centimeter. Cut surface showing gray white firm expand cell tumor mass of 10 centimeter and another two masses of 5 centimeter and 3 centimeter in diameter. And the diagnosis is multiple intramural leiomyomata of uterus. The points you need to remember is grossly we can see the firm gray white well circumscribed masses and the cut surface showing cut surface is furrowed appearance and there are three types based on the location intramural subserosal and submucosal. Microscopically the cells are these cells are spindle shape with moderate to abundant amount of cytoplasm with normal appearing benign appearing centrally placed nucleus with which is cigar in shape with perinuclear halo. Okay, this is the end of the topic. If you want to take the screenshot of these notes. Okay, you can leave the class. Place your attendance in the chat box and leave the class.